the second book of the Chronicles, chapter 1. And Solomon, the son of David, was strengthened in his kingdom, and the Lord his God was with him and magnified him exceedingly. Then Solomon spake unto all Israel, to the captains of thousands and of hundreds, and to the judges, and to every governor in all Israel, chief of their fathers. So Solomon and all the congregation with him went to the high place that was at Gibeon, for there was the tabernacle of the congregation of God, which Moses the servant of the Lord had made in the wilderness. But the ark of God had David brought up from Kirjath-Jearim to the place which David had prepared for it, for he had pitched a tent for it at Jerusalem. Moreover, the brazen altar that Bezaleel, the son of Uri, the son of Hur, had made, he put before the tabernacle of the Lord, and Solomon and the congregation sought unto it. And Solomon went up thither to the brazen altar before the Lord, which was at the tabernacle of the congregation, and offered 1,000 burnt offerings upon it. In that night did God appear unto Solomon, and said unto him, Ask what I should give thee. And Solomon said unto God, Thou hast shewed great mercy unto David my father, and hast made me to reign in his stead. Now, O Lord God, let thy promise unto David my father be established, for thou hast made me king over a people like the dust of the earth in multitude. Give me now wisdom and knowledge, that I may go out and come in before this people. For who can judge this thy people that is so great? And God said to Solomon, Because this was in thine heart, and thou hast not asked riches, wealth, or honor, nor the life of thine enemies, neither yet asked long life, but hast asked wisdom and knowledge for thyself, that thou mayest judge my people over whom I have made thee king. Wisdom and knowledge is granted unto thee, and I will give thee riches and wealth and honor such as none of the kings have had that have been before thee, neither shall there any after thee have the like. Then Solomon came from his journey to the high place that was at Gibeon to Jerusalem, from before the tabernacle of the congregation, and reigned over Israel. And Solomon gathered chariots and horsemen, and he had 1,400 chariots, and 12,000 horsemen, which he placed in the chariot cities, and with the king in Jerusalem. And the king made silver and gold at Jerusalem as plenteous as stones, and cedar trees made he as the sycamore trees that are in the vale for abundance. And Solomon had horses brought out of Egypt in linen yarn. The king's merchants received the linen yarn at a price. And they fetched up and brought forth out of Egypt a chariot for 600 shekels of silver, and horse for 150. And so brought they out horses for all the kings of the Hittites and for the kings of Syria by their means. Chapter 2. And Solomon determined to build an house for the name of the Lord, and an house for his kingdom. And Solomon told out 70,000 men to bear burdens, and 80,000 to hew in the mountain, and 3,600 to oversee them. And Solomon sent to Huram, the king of Tyre, saying, that's Hiram, people call it, the head mason, is that Tits deal with David, my father, and Tits sent him cedars to build him an house to dwell therein, even so deal with me. Behold, I build an house to the name of the Lord my God to dedicate it to him and to burn before him sweet incense and for the continual shewbread and for the burnt offerings morning and evening on the Sabbaths and on the new moons and on the solemn feasts of the Lord our God. This is an ordinance forever to Israel. And the house which I build is great, for great is our God above all gods. But who is able to build him an house, seeing the heaven and heaven of heavens cannot contain him? Who am I then that I should build him an house save only to burn sacrifice before him? Send me now, therefore, a man cunning to work in gold and in silver and in brass and in iron and in purple and crimson and blue, and that can skill to grave with the cunning men that are with me in Judah and Jerusalem, whom David my father did provide. Send me also cedar trees, fir trees, and algum trees out of Lebanon, for I know that thy servants can skill to cut timber in Lebanon, and behold, my servants shall be with thy servants, even to prepare me timber in abundance, for the house which I am about to build shall be wonderful great. And behold, I will give thy servants, the hewers that cut timber, 20,000 measures of beaten wheat, and 20,000 measures of barley, and 20,000 baths of wine, and 20,000 baths of oil. Then Aram the king of Tyre answered in writing, which he sent to Solomon, because the Lord hath loved his people, he hath made thee king over them. Aram said moreover, blessed be the Lord God of Israel that made heaven and earth, who hath given to David the king a wise son, endued with prudence and understanding, that might build an house for the Lord and an house for his kingdom. And now I have sent a cunning man, endued with understanding, of Aram, my father's, the son of a woman of the daughters of Dan, and his father was a man of Tyre.
They're talking about Hiram. Let's read that again.
And now I have sent a cunning man, endued with understanding, of Aram, my father's.
Okay. This next sentence, I don't understand how these two sentences relate. But I have a chart now. And so Hiram was born of a woman of Dan and a man of Tyre, who is from the tribe of Naphtali. So the dad, Hiram's dad, was a man of Tyre, from the tribe of Naphtali. And the mother was from the tribe of Dan, and Hiram is the son. So this verse says, the son of a woman of the daughters of Dan, and his father was a man of Tyre. So maybe they're not talking of Hiram, but Hiram is exactly that too. Maybe they're sending someone exactly like that. Because that's who they're calling Hiram, H-U-R. H-I, in this book. But that's his genealogy also. So I don't understand this. Again, 13. And now I have sent a cunning man, endued with understanding, of Hiram, my father's. And then it has a comma. And then it starts off with a capital. the son of a woman of the... It must be talking about Hiram. Skillful to... Okay, the son of a woman of the daughters of Dan, and his father was a man of Tyre. Okay. That's Hiram. Skillful to work in gold and in silver and brass and iron and stone and in timber and purple and blue and in fine linen and in crimson, also to grave any manner of graving and to find out every device which shall be put to him with thy cunning men and with the cunning men of my lord David thy father. Now therefore the wheat and the barley, the oil and the wine which my lord hath spoken of, let him send unto his servants, and we will cut wood out of Lebanon as much as thou shalt need, and we will bring it to thee in floats by sea to Joppa.
Floats to Joppa. That must be somehow at the Euphrates River, somehow. Jordan River, maybe.
I got this really good chart now. It was in the 1611 Bible, King James Version, from this guy called Kurt Mayo on YouTube. He put it up there. It's amazing. That's how I could just figure that out right now. And I'm glad. And I already, and it says it in particular. They don't say the name just like this. It says the son of a woman of the daughters of Dan. So it was a female from the tribe of Dan, and the male was from Tyre. Furthermore, he was from the tribe of Naphtali, and those two tribes are closely associated. So, this is their son, this Hiram. And Solomon numbered all the strangers that were in the land of Israel after the numbering wherewith David his father had numbered them. And they were found 150,000.